Hey, it's Cruiser, where I show you how to make great drone videos. Today, I'm showing you how to register your drone with the FAA. It's very important to get your drone registered with the FAA. It takes about 5 minutes, costs $5, and lasts for 3 years. If you don't do it and you get stopped by local authorities, you could get charged up to a $250,000 fine.
$250,000 fine.
So it's very important to do this absolutely when you get your drone.
What you'll want to do is go to FAADroneZone.faa.gov. It'll take you to this website. And what you'll want to start doing is going to the register here under Fly SUAS under Part 107. Click on it here and then it'll have you create an account. You need to be 13 years or older and have a valid email address. Since I've already created one, and if you already have one, you can go back to login. Or creating an account for the first time, they'll have you go through this legal jargon and agree to it. I'm gonna log in real quick, so the video might cut out for a second. It'll take you to this screen next, and what you'll do in this screen is fill out your applicant information. So this will be your first and last name, title, phone number, etc. Part 107 account information, just click this box right here, use your first and last name for the Part 107 account name, physical address, and then if your physical is the same as your mailing address, then you can click this as well. I'm going to fill this out real quick, and then click proceed to dashboard. So now you're on your Part 107 dashboard. It'll show inventory of Part 107 users, showing one total user. That's myself, who had just registered. Inventory, you do not have any registered SUASs. This would be your drones. If you have multiple, I just have one, so I'm gonna manage my SUAS inventory. And then you're gonna add one. So then what you do is click on add UAS. It'll ask if it's home built or purchased, the nickname of your drone, then it'll ask for the manufacturer. In this case, it could be DJI or a different manufacturer. The model, so if you had a DJI Phantom 3 standard, you would enter that there. And then the serial number, this is if you have one on your drone. If you don't, serial number not applicable. And then click add UAS. I've already done that here. Go to checkout. And then it's gonna have acknowledgement of FAA requirements. And those are basic things like not flying at night, flying out of the 5 mile radius of a airport, staying under 400 feet. But check it out to be safe. Make sure you understand those. I read, understand, tend to follow the FAA requirements. And then go through your payment information. Then it's gonna come to review and pay. I'll ask for billing address, payment info, and then the checkout. This is the drone that you just registered. Check this checkbox right here. Click pay. Congratulations, you have successfully registered your devices. Your registration certificate has been sent to the email address you provided in your registration, and then you can also print it by return to your registered inventory. Now, this picture right here is very useful. This is where you want to put it on your drone, is right on the front of it where the camera is. One of the things I'm going to put in the description is a link to a sticker that you can buy where you can put your drone registration number on there and then stick that on your drone just in case you need to re-register your drone later after 3 years of having it. And if you ever want to go back later and manage or edit information about your drone or the accounts, register for new users or register new drones, this is where you go, FAADroneZone.faa.gov.
Hey, thanks for checking out my video. Make sure to go and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos on how to make great drone videography. As well, check out my playlist of places I've been with my drone. In the meantime, have a wonderful, amazing day.